guys, it's Melvin 7 here. Today I'm bringing you episode 10 of my transfer rumours. Now, I apologise if the light behind me is getting to it. Like, I don't have curtains yet. I've just moved in like this week, so I need to sort all that out. So I've tried to lower the exposure as much as possible. Like, it was really, really bright before, but I've toned it down and now you can just see like blue bits around my head. So hopefully it's not too bad to watch. If it is, I apologise and I'll try and get it sorted as soon as possible. I know lighting's always been an issue in my videos, to be perfectly honest, and I'll try and sort that ASAP. But anyway, on to the episode. So I've got a lot to talk about because I haven't done an episode of this for 3 days. Don't worry, they'll come every day or two during the Euros, and then I'll go back to daily after the Euros. So anyway, Luis Hernandez is the first player we've got. It's a confirmed transfer from Spain to Leicester. Free transfer, literally his contract ends in July, so it's just one of those that's going to be completely free. Don't know too much about him. He's a centre-back though, and he's joining Premier League champions Leicester. I think he's 27, 28, something about that. He's got a lot of experience, especially in La Liga, so we'll see what he does for Leicester. Next player we've got is Ounas. I think is how you pronounce it. It's a Bordeaux winger who's been heavily linked to Manchester United. This is because, well, it's not because, he was linked before this, but then he followed Manchester United on Twitter. He also followed a few United players and Manchester United on Instagram as well. And he's been heavily linked with French tabloids and news stations to join Manchester United. And yeah, I'm not sure like if we bought him, if he would play in the first season or if we just loan him back to Bordeaux, perhaps, because we do have a lot of players and we're heavily linked to Mbolo as well. It's confirmed that we've started negotiations with him. We've asked Jojo Mendes to help. So if we did get both of those, along with other players we're linked with, particularly because we've got Martial, we've got Rashford, a lot of young players, Yanazai as well, like, is he going to get another chance? We'll have to wait and see, but it's good because people forget that potentially we've got 50-60 games next season because of Europa League, and obviously that goes on for quite a while. And then if we go far in the Cups and then the Premier League games, you know, 50-60 games, you're going to really need rotational options. We started the season last season with Rooney and Memphis as strikers, and we didn't get Martial until deadline day, and obviously Rashford was playing for the under-18s at the start of the season. So yeah, it's better to have options. So if we did get this player, obviously I'd be very excited to see what he can do. If he could be another Martial-esque player, someone who well, we bought, I think the fee for this player is roughly about 8 million, so it's a lot less than Martial, and obviously I'm not expecting as big a fireworks if he did join, because Martial literally hit the ground running straight away with that goal against Liverpool. But anyway, talking about this for too long, let's see if it happens. Ounas, the winger. Next player, we've got Remy, reportedly going to Fenerbahce. Now, this is a player that should have left Chelsea last season. I think he probably wanted to, but unfortunately he couldn't. And then every time he got an opening, when Diego Costa was injured, he was injured, so he just never really got game time. So a move away seems quite realistic, and Fenerbahce is a club that are in Champions League, so again, quite a realistic team, and I'm sure Remy would excel for Fenerbahce. Next player we've got is someone that's undergoing a medical right now, and that's Victor Wanyama for a relatively cheap fee of 12 million. I presume that's because Southampton promised him he could move this season, because he wanted to move last season when Arsenal were interested. I think it was Arsenal. And yeah, the reported fee was 20, 25 million. But now I think they've just literally accepted the first bid because they had a mutual agreement with Wanyama that he could leave. And it happened to be Spurs. And now he's undergoing a medical. This is a fantastic buy for Spurs. It gives them competition, especially with Eric Dier, but he can play as a centre-back. And also Moussa Dembele, gives them more options, and they've got a lot more strength in depth. That's something that Spurs need to work on this season, and I'm sure Pochettino knows that. They've got a very solid first lineup, but they don't have a lot of depth for when those players inevitably eventually get injured. So this is a fantastic buy for Spurs, and it's relatively cheap, so I reckon this could be a huge, huge signing. Next player we've got linked is Townsend. He was originally linked to Liverpool until the Liverpool Echo said that they have no interest whatsoever. Liverpool do not have interest in Andros Townsend, but there's very small whispers of Manchester City potentially being linked. Now, this would be a terrible move for Townsend because he'd just be another Delph or another Patrick Roberts purely to be there so City can meet their English quota, you know, the amount of English players you have to have playing for the club, so he could go down in the list. Like, he probably would get game time now and again, but considering Sterling doesn't even get game time and they spent 50 million on him, and they're probably going to buy other players as well, like, this would be a good move for Manchester City because it gives them more depth. But for Townsend, this would be pathetic. Like, I know Newcastle are in the Championship, but if he did want to move, which apparently he doesn't anyway, but if he did, then it would be, he would be better suited going to a team, like a mid-table team in the Premier League where he's going to start every single game. But yeah, those are the links as of now. I don't think he'll move to either Man City or Liverpool, but again, they're linked. Well, particularly Man City now. Now we've got Morata, a player that the Juventus, I think sporting directors came out and said that Real Madrid are exercising their buyback clause. It's only 32 million euros, I think, or 38. I think it's 32 million. And this could purely be so Real Madrid could sell him again, because I'm not sure if Morata would want to stay or whether Real Madrid have got other targets. Like, they're heavily linked to Pogba now, where the agent has confirmed. Mino Raiola, who's also Ibra and Mkhitaryan's agent, but he's confirmed that Real Madrid have begun early negotiations. No bids as of yet, but he's in the Euros anyway, so it won't take too long. But as for Morata, he's linked to Arsenal and Chelsea when he goes to Real Madrid. It's a matter of when, not if, he goes back to Real Madrid, but the question is whether they'll sell him again for a second time. The reported fee they apparently want when he rejoins Real Madrid is 75 million euros, which is roughly about 57, 60 million. So if he came to the Premier League, that might just about be a new British record. Obviously, that is Angel Di Maria for 59.7 million to Manchester United. So if it hit the 60 million mark, it would be a new Premier League record. And it remains to be seen if Chelsea or Arsenal would pay that kind of money. But we'll see. For now, it looks as though he's going back to Real Madrid. He's in the Euros anyway, so if nothing will happen with this play until after. He might go to Real Madrid because the buyout clause and all that, the buyback. But he won't move again until after the Euros, so we've got plenty of time with this one. Next player, we've got a confirmed bid, well, two bids, for Michael Keane and Troy Deeney by the same club, Leicester City, the Premier League champions. They got a 10 million bid rejected for Michael Keane, who is a player that plays for Burnley, I believe. We sold him, Manchester United, for 2 million last season, and or was it the season before? But yeah, now Burnley are rejecting 10 million for this player. He's a defender, he's young, he's English, and well, I haven't really followed him since he left Manchester United, but I assume he's done something very good for Leicester to be bidding that sort of money. But Troy Deeney, they've bid 20 million, then they bid 25 million and got rejected. But now it's being reported that they're willing to match Watford's 30 million asking price. 30 million for Troy Deeney. What? He's a good player, but 15 million tops. That's absolute max, but 30 million, like, geez, Leicester must be desperate, like, to get a striker. I'm not saying that as a bad thing, but, well, you know what I mean? Like, 30 million, surely there's other options. Troy Deeney's a decent player, but I'm just surprised Leicester would bid that sort of money for him. Like, if it was one of the, what you would call big clubs, the rich clubs, then it wouldn't be too much of a shock. But considering it's Leicester bidding 30 million potentially, that's astonishing. And we'll have to wait and see what he does, if and when he actually does move. Next, well, it's not a player, we've got a manager linked. And that's Manchester United's favourite, Louis van Gaal, who is linked to AC Milan. And this is probably one. He's on the shortlist, and I think he's one of the favourites, but there's other managers going in for it. I think the only one that's been confirmed that he probably won't join is Manuel Pellegrini, I think. So we'll have to wait and see. But Louis van Gaal, I don't know. I don't know if AC Milan would enjoy Van Gaal's tactics. We've had to endure them for 2 years. I didn't really enjoy it. Like, it was terrible football. We won a trophy though, so you never know. He might win I don't know what it's called, the Serie A's version of the FA Cup. I'm not sure what it's called, but he might win that. You never know. The Italian Cup, we'll call it for sake of argument. But if he did join. I'd be interested to see what he did. I mean, he did get us fourth in the first year, so maybe he could try and get AC Milan closer to that, but I just don't know. Like, I'm surprised he hasn't retired. He said Manchester United would be his last job, but it was cut short a year, so I could see this happening, but we'll have to wait and see with that one. Next player we've got is someone I don't think will go, but it's Daley Blind, and he's linked to Arsenal, and funnily enough, in the first season when he was here, on my first FM career that I did in 2015, Arsenal bid for Daley Blind, and it was like a stupid amount, so I accepted it, and he went to Arsenal. But that's got nothing to do with real life. It's just an interesting fact, I suppose. But yeah, I can't see us selling Daley Blind, particularly to a Premier League rival like Arsenal. I just think it's reports like Mourinho isn't the sort of manager that quickly disestablishes a team, like quickly mass sells players. It's reported by Manchester Evening News, I think, that he's texted every single Manchester United player wishing them well for the Euros and saying they've got an opportunity to prove themselves before he sells anyone. So should we eventually sell Daley Blind, even though he's not competing in the Euros because Netherlands aren't there, I don't think it's going to happen until after our pre-season tour. So yeah, we'll have to wait a long time for this one. But if he did go, I just can't see it being Arsenal. It would be a good signing for Arsenal because he's very versatile. And that's why I think he's better used as a rotation option for us, because he can play as a centre-back now. He can play as a CDM, a left-back. Very versatile. Could probably play other positions if you really wanted him to. And he's a composed, intelligent footballer. We don't have too many of them on our team. So yeah, I just can't see this one happening. Next player we've got is Pogba, as I briefly touched on before. Real Madrid have started early negotiations, as his agent has confirmed. So yeah, it looks as though this will probably be Real Madrid's marquee signing, and it would be probably somewhere in the region for 70-80 million, and I'd be gutted if he did go to Real Madrid, but the likelihood is that he is. So the likelihood is one of their big midfielders will probably go, and the most likely one is James Rodriguez, and he's been heavily linked to us. He's been heavily linked to a few other teams, but yeah, that's one player I wouldn't really want us to sign. I think I've went through that in another video. I mean, he's got potential, but his off the pitch attitude just seems to be really, really bad. He seems to just not have the work ethic, especially that someone like Jose Mourinho demands. So yeah, that's really early links. But anyway, it's on about Pogba for this one. So if he did go to Real Madrid, that would be ridiculous. They'd have Toni Kroos, Luka Modric, Paul Pogba. Like, Jesus Christ, what a midfield. Casemiro as well, he's very underrated. And that would be scary. But the last player we've got is update number 5 million on Henrik Mkhitaryan. But every single day, it seems, his agent, Mino Raiola, seems to be bigging up a move to Manchester United, and bigger quotes every single day. It's got to the point today where he said Manchester United is Mkhitaryan's dream club, and the opportunity might not come next year because Manchester United might have already got another player, or you know, will be going after different targets. So he said that the opportunity is there, so you'd be stupid to not go for it. He also said that he wouldn't go for it if he didn't think there was a huge possibility of it happening. And basically, he's just bigging it up. Like, he wants Manchester United to pay the 31 million that Dortmund demand for a player who's got 1 year left on his contract. I think he had 18 goals and 24 assists in the German Bundesliga last season. And he played for Borussia Dortmund, who came second by about 5-6 points. And he was one of their most influential players alongside Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. So I've been through my thoughts so many times about this player. It's a player I really want. And I don't care if Leicester are bidding 30 million for Troy Deeney, even though he's got 1 year left on his contract, we have to put that 31 million down. And that's what Raiola keeps trying to get. We've bid, reported by Damasio, 25 million euros, which equates to about 18, 20 million. So yeah, we just need to up that, and effectively he's ours. Borussia Dortmund widely reported that they don't want to sell him, but they will accept a bid in the region of around 31 million. So we should do that. And this would be a perfect player for us. And he's a versatile player as well, but primarily on the right is probably where we'd play him. So yeah, that's my roundup for today. Longest episode yet, purely because I didn't do one for 3 to 4 days. If there's enough rumours, I'll have one tomorrow. If not, it'll be in 2 days. But yeah, there won't be another gap of 3-4 days. So don't worry about that. But hopefully you have enjoyed. Subscribe if you haven't already. Like the video. And yeah, peace.